this video, we are going to see a problem on hexagonal pyramid. Here is the question. A hexagonal pyramid of 35 mm side of base and 65 mm axis length rests on its base on HP with one of its side of base perpendicular to VP. It is cut by a section plane making an angle of 30 degree with VP and is 15 mm away from the axis of pyramid. Draw the top view, sectional front view, sectional side view and true shape of the section. So this is the question we have. Now whatever the conditions are there in this question, I'll explain it step by step. First, by reading it, we understood that the type of solid is a hexagonal pyramid. So I'll draw the diagram for that. So here is the diagram of a hexagonal pyramid, and as we see here, it has a hexagonal base. It means there are six corners and those corners are connected to a common vertex called as apex. And here we have a hexagonal base. Then there are six slant edges and six triangular faces. In this hexagonal pyramid. And now the condition is hexagonal pyramid of 35 mm side of base and 65 mm axis length rest on its base on HP. See, if it is resting in HP, it is resting in this condition which I have shown here on the ground, and then when we are looking from top, we are going to see the hexagonal base. If it was resting in VP, in that case from the front view we would have seen that hexagonal base, but here since it is resting in HP, we are going to see the hexagonal base from top. Next, rest on its base on HP with one of its side of base perpendicular to VP. So it is resting with one of the sides perpendicular. Now how to draw that, I'll explain it in the solution. So let us get started with the solution to this problem. Now, in this question, as we have to draw the top view, sectional front view, sectional side view and true shape of the section, so it is better to start with the top view from the middle, because here we are going to get on both the sides. One side there will be side view and on the other side there will be true shape of the section. So for that, I'll start drawing it from the middle. That is the hexagon which I am going to draw, of which we are going to see from the top. Here we want 35 mm side of base, so measuring the radius equal to 35, taking this as the radius and drawing a right circle. And now here we want the hexagonal pyramid resting in such a way that with one of its side of base perpendicular to VP, So for that, I'll keep the point here having the same radius, which was 35. Cutting the circle at two locations from the top, similarly from the bottom. Joining all these points in order. Then I'll be giving the notations to it. So here we have point 1, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th and 6th. Here is the apex, point O, and then joining all the corners of the base to the apex. Now after getting this pyramid, this is the top view. So after getting the top view of this hexagonal pyramid, I'll project the front view. And for that, all the points needs to be projected upwards. Axis height is 65 mm. So measuring 65 mm. Here is the apex O dash, then 1 dash and 2 dash, 3 dash, 6 dash, this is 4 dash, comma 5 dash. Now after getting the front view of the hexagonal pyramid, then next I have to place the cutting plane. I cannot make this pyramid dark directly, I have to cut it. So here it is given, it is cut by a section plane making an angle of 30 degree with VP. Now this angle of 30 degree with VP will be seen in HP and is 15 mm away from the axis of the pyramid. So for this condition, here we can say that the axis of the pyramid appears in the top view in the form of a point. Then since the cutting plane is 15 mm away from the axis, which is looking like a point in the top view, I'll take this distance 15 and then through it marking an angle of 30. But now if we are marking this angle as 30, then the distance will not remain 15. So for that, I'll use another method. In that case, keeping this 2 to 5 line on which there is axis as the reference, I'll drop a perpendicular. Now over this perpendicular line, I'll mark the distance 15. Next, keeping this as the reference, drawing a horizontal line through it. And now keeping this point as the reference, I'll measure the angle as 30. So now if I measure the distance from the origin or from the apex up to the cutting plane, this line indicates the cutting plane, and then I'm going to get the distance as 15. So first I'll make this cutting plane dark so that we can understand how much portion remains and what is cut and removed. So this is the cutting plane. Next, here is the top view, and when we are showing the cutting plane in the top view, it means the sectional view will be available in the front view. For that, observer is here in the top. Now when I'll be cutting this hexagonal pyramid, I will be replacing the portion which is closer to observer. So this portion, bottom portion, is closer to the observer. This will be removed and this top portion will be retained. So I will make the retained portion dark. So this is the retained portion which I have made dark. It means whatever is remaining, I have shown it in light, this much portion has been removed. And here is the direction of viewing. So the cutting plane, I'll name it cutting plane A dash. Next, I'll mark the points where it is cutting this hexagonal pyramid. Now since edge 2 to 3 it is cutting at this location, I'll give that as point A. Where it is cutting O to 3, I'll give that as point B. Where it is cutting O to 4, that will be point C. And at last, where it is cutting this edge 4 to 5, here I'll say that is point D. Now after getting all these points, I'll project them into the front view. So first, starting with point A, it is on edge 2 to 3. So we have 2 dash 3 dash on XY line. So here I'll be getting point A dash. Then point B is on O to 3. Now just see the method how I'm going to project this point B. It won't be projected directly as it is. Here is a method that you should measure the distance from the center up to that point which is at the center, like here it is on center. So I'll be measuring the distance up to point B, then making it parallel with the horizontal line, I am going to draw this arc here. Now this point B has been shifted here, so this is the location of point B. I made it parallel with the horizontal line. Now projecting it upwards. Onto the slant edge. And then after projecting it to the slant edge, where it is cutting that slant edge, I'll mark the point and then transfer it onto this edge O dash 3 dash because it is lying on O to 3. So this is the method by which any point which is located exactly at the center, that will be projected. Now this will be the point B dash. Then for C dash, it is lying on O to 4. So I'll project it is on O dash 4 dash. So that will give me the point C dash. So now here I'll be projecting the remaining points. After point C dash, point D dash, and D dash is on this same location where there is 4 dash 5 dash, because point 4, D and 5. When we are looking from this direction, all these points will be at the same location. So here is point D dash, same location. Next, I'll be joining these points in order to get the shape of the cut section. So A dash, B dash will be joined. B dash to C dash. And finally C dash is, it is already connected to D dash. Next, I'll make it dark. So the apex is retained here, it is not cut and removed, as we can see from the top view also. The apex is retained. This edge is dark from O dash to B. OB is an edge which is visible from the top view and in the front view also. So it will be made dark. Next, from O dash to 1 dash, 2 dash is connected. Now this is the cut section portion. I have to make the section lines for it, and here I'll draw a line inclined at 45 degree with the horizontal. Joining it with light line first, then I'll make parallel lines through it. So these are the sectioning lines which we have to show for the cut section portion or the cut portion. So this is the sectional front view. Next, I'll project the sectional side view, and for that observer will be here, that is onto the right hand side, and projecting all the points on left hand side, that is I'm going to draw the right hand side view towards left. And because if we are looking from the left hand side, then this cut portion won't be visible, so we have to look from the right hand side. And for that purpose, I'll mark a point here. Drawing a 45 degree line. And then I'll have to project the pyramid in the side view. So giving the notations, this will be O double dash, here we have the point, 6 double dash, this will be 3 double dash, joining it to the apex. Even the points 1 and 5 needs to be projected. I'll be giving the notations here. Here we have 1 double dash and 5 double dash, then 2 double dash and 4 double dash. Next, these points needs to be projected in the side view. So if we see here, point B dash, B was on O 2 3 and here we have O double dash 3 double dash. So first projecting point B directly. This will give me B double dash. Then point A. A is on this edge 2 to 3. So instead of getting it from the front view, we cannot get it from here. It is on XY line. So directly I'll project it from the top view. And here we have edge 2 double dash 3 double dash. So it will be intersecting that edge. So here we have this point, which is A double dash. Then the remaining points, point C dash is on O to 4 and here we have O double dash 4 double dash. Projecting C dash on O double dash 4 double dash, that gives me C double dash. Then point D dash, again I'll get D dash from the top view and here it is cutting edge 4 to 5. We already have 4 double dash 5 double dash here, so this point D is already been projected. So D is here at this location, that gives me D double dash. Then joining these points in the proper sequence, so connecting A double dash with B double dash, B double dash with C double dash and C double dash with D double dash. So this will be the cut section portion of this pyramid, or we can say the side view of this pyramid. Now I'll make this dark, whatever is visible. So A double dash to B double dash is visible, will be made dark. Next, B double dash and C double dash will be connected. C double dash to D double dash connected. And now if we see in this diagram, these points A, 3 and B, they are removed. So if we see A double dash, 3 double dash and B double dash, this portion won't be made dark because it is cut and removed, as we can see from the top view. Now whatever remains, that is O to B, means O double dash to B double dash, will be made dark. Then O to C, that is O double dash C double dash, will be made dark. Next, O to 5 and O to 1 are connected. O to 6, so O double dash, 6 double dash connected. then here this center portion won't be connected because O2D is not an edge. This will indicate the axis. So here I'm drawing that axis. Next, this is the cut section. I have to draw sectioning lines over it like I have drawn in the front view. Now, after getting the top view, sectional front view and sectional side view, we have to also draw the true shape of the section. And for that, I will have to make the cutting plane parallel. Since cutting plane is in HP, I'll make it parallel in HP. So drawing a light line. Next, measuring the length of the cutting plane. Cutting plane length I have to take in such a way where it is cutting the solid. So starting from point A, where it is in contact with the solid, up to point D. This much is the length of the cutting plane. Keeping a point here, marking it. So here, this is point A and D. So A and D. Next, for points B and C, I'll have to measure the distance from A to B. And then from B to C. Next, after getting these points, I'll be projecting them into VP. So wherever A and A dash intersect, that's going to give me the point A double dash, then point B. So here there is B dash. So wherever point B and B dash intersects, that gives me B double dash. Next, point C. And here C dash. Wherever C and C dash intersects, that gives me the point C double dash. At last, point D. So wherever D dash, D and D dash intersects, that gives me the point D double dash. Now joining them in sequence. A double dash to B double dash, B to C, and C to D. So this is the true shape of the section. Then the section plane. So this is the cutting plane, or we can say the section plane. AA dash. This is the true shape of the section. So this is the true shape of the section. Next, after drawing the true shape, here we have already completed top view, front view and side view. I'll give it the dimensioning. Edge of waist 35, axis height is 65. 35 and then the axis height here is 65 and here is the inclination of the cutting plane. I can give the dimensioning in this way that the cutting plane is inclined at 30 degree to VP seen in HP. And with this, we complete the problem.